विज्ञान विद्यापीठ के 2008
रिकॉर्ड दिल्ली
Delhi Center convocation opens now. For that, on behalf of Free General Center Kochi, I cordially invite our guest of honor of the convocation, Professor Dr. R. Shashitharan, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Kochi University of Science and Technology, and our respected Regional Director, Ma'am, Dr. Gayle Sturdy, or to the dais. Please, Ma'am and Sir. Our assistant registrar, Sri K.K. Joseph sir, to present the bouquet to our guest of honor, Professor Dr. R. Shashitharan. Thank you, sir. Now I request our regional director, ma'am, to welcome our chief guest and present the report of the activities of the regional center.
Of the convocation, Professor Dr. R. Shashitharan, Vice Chancellor, Kochi University of Science and Technology, distinguished guests, chief guests of the function, and ladies and gentlemen, press and media, and invited special invitees, and dear learners. It is a privilege to be with you all and invited to this 32nd convocation and present this report. As of now, we have around 3,000 learners to receive the degree, and who are part of it who have come to collect the plate face to face. And talking about the guest of honor here, Professor Shashitharan has a teaching experience of over 30 years and currently is the Vice Chancellor, and he travelled across so many posts for us, and he is also a part of the distance learning system of IGNU, being a member of our formulating all the Hindi related programs in our Indira Gandhi National Open University. Talking about the IRS, I have given the full report which is available also in for the press and media with Dr. Prasitha Unnikrishna. I just want to just brief it so that we can just move, give more space for other activities. We have the teaching learning situation jumping with new activities and new programs and new learning support centers established for, but the credit goes to the previous regional directors Dr. Rajesh and Dr. Sindhu Nair for initiating the establishment of these four centers under Kochi Regional Center. And we have the extension activities through the Swachh Bharat at Ayampura village and Mulathuruthi village for the digital literacy initiative. And we are proud to have three academics at regional center who initiated under the former regional director Dr. M. Rajesh as contributors for the online program in the SWAYAM platform. And the Indira Gandhi National University, the competent authority, are very large-hearted to provide continuing education opportunity for the academics. We have three assistant regional directors and one assistant director post. All four of them have attended FDP and refresher programs the last year. And when it comes to resource sourcing also, and sharing, our academics have been a part of many of the seminars and workshops, and even to the refresher program and the orientation program of staff colleges. And the Gandhi Jayanti celebrations, as per the UGC letter, was also celebrated by singing the bhajans of Gandhiji for continuously from 2nd to 9th October. And the Voter Day celebrations was also initiated in 2019. And we have also given the official learning training to the town official language implementation committee to ensure that Hindi, use of Hindi language is prominent in our official procedure. And on 11th November 2018, we organized a workshop on e-support services, which was participated around 41 participants. And when it comes to the terminal examination conductor, we have examinees spreading over 52,000 around 52,000 in June 2018 and 48,000 in December 2018. And we have used the part-time faculty who have served as observers for the conduct of the exams. And we have also transmitted around 38,000 awards, assignment awards for June 2018 and 29,000 awards for December 2018. And we ensure that there is inclusive education. We have provided assistance, special assistance to the differently enabled learners during the conduct of the terminal examination. And we have the Innovation Club. If you have just listened to the recent report, it was started in September. So every month we have the enrichment session under the Innovation Club. And when it comes to the new initiatives of the university, we have the e-content of the study material available in the Gyankosh and also for a fee concession provided to the learners. And we always depend on the part-time faculty of empanelment as academic counselors. So the online application for the empanelment of academic counselors has been enforced as a policy decision towards the digital initiative of the university. And we are also extremely to have a report that as per VC report, we have 3832 learners collecting the degree, diploma and certificate under Cochin Regional Center. And we also have 3 gold medalists with us. It's worth it to mention that Sri Sajid Kumar for MA Philosophy, Madam Anju Anna John for MSW Counseling, and Ms. Tansi Shanul for postgraduate diploma in computer applications. We didn't discuss, I didn't discuss with VC or Professor Naidu to tell about this. I encourage you to, but the message was shared already, that is to make use of the SWAYAM platform, which is free of cost now, and also the SWAYAMPRABHA and the NPTEL. I am not promoting because our staff are part of the national faculty for the SWAYAM platform, but it will be beneficial for you because it's learning anywhere, and at any time. And at present, there is no registration fee and there is only examination fee if you want to take your certificate. With that, I congratulate you also. Lifelong learning is not only with IGNU, also with the online program. And we would like to, rather we would expect you to come and join some other program. If not a full certificate or a degree or a diploma, at least an associate student. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your brief report highlighting the activities and achievements of Regional Center Kochi. Now, I cordially invite our guest honor of the convocation address.
Inspector Dr. J.S. Dorothy, Regional Director, Indira Gandhi Open University Regional Center, Kochi. Distinguished dignitaries and the students, parents, media persons, Sabko Mera Namaskar. I am extremely happy to be a part of this 32nd convocation program of Indira Gandhi National Open University at Kochi. IGNU is playing an important role in opening up the doors of education to lots of students across the country to pursue higher education on a wide variety of subjects since 1985. IGNU has truly democratized the access to higher education. India has more than 900 universities now. However, we have 1.32 billion population. That means we need many more number of universities. Our current gross enrollment ratio, GER, in higher education is 25.8%. More number of students are unable to pursue higher education due to several factors. The limited number of seats in higher education is one of the important factors. Lots of people appear for entrance examination for a few seats in universities and colleges, but we cannot offer a seat to many talented students. At the same time, without the power of knowledge acquired through education, we cannot survive in the present knowledge society. Here is the importance of IGNU. With a minimum fee, IGNU offers quality higher education to all. The doors of IGNU are open to large number of students across the country, ensuring quality learning materials and well-qualified teachers. IGNU is actively making their presence on the online world with virtual classrooms. We know that IGRO study methods are widely used by many institutions to teach their regular students. It is because the study materials are prepared by highly eminent scholars in the country on each subject. I think this is the age of open higher education. I mean massive open online courses, MOOC, MOOC, massive open online courses. Students can pursue courses offered by any university across the globe through MOOC. IGRO is one of the major providers of MOOCs in India. Actually, it is an extension of the distance education program started by IGRO long years back. In this context, I congratulate all the students on their successful completion of various courses. I hope the knowledge and skills you acquired through IGRO will empower you in life. It will help you to compete in your field. I wish that you can go to higher studies and become real winners in life, because knowledge is the real source of power in modern society. It is the most democratic source of power. You can share the knowledge, empower many others. With these few words, I conclude my speech. Thank you to all.
Our Chief Guest, Pallini Mannattam, please ma'am. Karin sir has a teaching experience of 30 years, out of which 18 years, 7 years as professor, Department of Hindi and Pusat. He also worked as reader at the Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kalari, and lecturer in senior scale director of Collegiate Education. Over his 30 years of research experience, he guided more than 50 students at MPhil and PhD level. So, thank you sir for coming and being the guest of honor for us. Now I invite your attention to say some remarkable notes that we are having 3 gold medals in Britain's Kochi. It is the proud moment for us to announce that these 3 gold medals, Mr. Sachin Kumar KT of, he won the gold